to make some artwork here. Well, the last time we shot one of these, I had my head in the shot the whole time, so it didn't really work very well. Let's get Photoshop up and running here. And as you can see, this was the last picture I produced. And I'm using a touchscreen. This is, it's all in silhouette for you, but there's the pen that I'm using. It's just a stylus. There's a little button on the one side here, and when you press it, it brings up a context menu. And so I'll be doing that quite a lot. It's really cool. Like when I when I'm using a brush and I press the context menu with my thumb here, I get to select brush sizes, so I can make really big thick lines if I want. And I have a little undo thing, that a little button that I program right there. You hit undo, bam, it's gone. So basically, it's a very simple setup, but it's great for making artwork. So let's bring up the layouts. I've drawn a fair number of the graphics here. I've got Liana running, and I've got an inking layer set up, and you can see I've already done a fair bit of the of this character. I'm just going to finish her off right now. So I've got the inking layer set up, and I'm just going to lay down some lines right over top of the pencil layer. And the pencil layer is really just, it's all digital, right? So there's not actually any penciling going on. I'll show you how I do that when I've done this. There we go. She's got some frayed sort of leggings here. Actually, I think I can do that a whole lot better. So here's my eraser tool. Take out the whole thing because it looks stupid. Try again. This time I'm going to take my time and try and follow the shape of her leg when I put these threads on. Here, and there's a little bit of frayed at the ends here. There's some toes. There we are. And something over here. I'm not going to draw a lot of background for this one because she's running quickly. I don't want to have backgrounds throughout the rest of the scene. And when you're running quickly, you don't really see the background, so I'm trying to get that effect. So there she is, zipping along there. I might put something in there. When you pull out the when I pull out the pencils, that's what it looks like. Leanna running on. Now you notice her foot's a little bit big. This happens a lot, I find, with digital artwork, is that you can focus, on one section of the paint of the image to the exclusion of everything else, and you get the scales incorrect. So we want to take that down. Now one thing I've done is in the preferences in this, you have an option for how it reduces and enlarges things, and right now I've got something called Next Nearest Neighbor, and keeps the edges hard, so it doesn't fuzz them out. So that's good, because when you go right in, you see how it's a nice hard edge. That's exactly what we want to maintain, because I like clean artwork. So we're going to select the whole leg, pull it out a bit. I go Control T, and it gives me a little dialogue, sets it up to shrink it down a bit. So we're just going to take down a little bit like that, and deselect. And there we go. Looks a little bit better. Tinker with the page. That's the nice thing, you can tinker to your heart's content when it's a digital image like this. So there we go. Now let's put some tone on this girl. I think she's running away from the light, so she's going to be... put her in some shadow here. And let's do this 38%. There she is. Just gonna put some shadow on the ground here. There we are. There's the Anna running. Let's get a nice close up so you can see that. Oops, it's pretty darn close there. There. Get that saved.